wedstrijd gewonnen op de Eurotour. Maar inmiddels heeft hij en Jamie Bain en Christo Reyes aan de zegenkar gebonden. Geef een hartelijk applaus. De Stack Attack. Robert Owen. En dan zijn tegenstander, een bekend gezicht natuurlijk, helemaal uit Australië is hij deze kant opgekomen om deel te nemen aan de Dutch Darts Masters. Hij won dit toernooi in 2012 en in dat jaar werd hij ook Europees kampioen. 5 Pro Tour zegens in de laatste 12 maanden. Dames en heren, The Wizard, Simon Whitlock!
We have already seen the defending champion secure his place in the quarterfinals, Michael van Gerwen seeing off Kyle Anderson. Now the turn of another champion of the Dutch Darts Masters, the 2012 winner Simon Whitlock, taking to the stage for the fourth match of the day here in Maastricht, up against a man in uncharted territory in the shape of Robert Owen, playing in the final day of a Euro Tour event for the first time in his career, and also in the very unfamiliar position of not being first on stage today. Served him well so far. Friday's action, he kicked things off with a 6-0 demolition of Jamie Bain, and then yesterday started day two with a 6-5 defeat of Christo Reyes. Can he make it a hat-trick? Rob Owen on the verge of a place in the quarterfinals on the European Tour. Tall order for him though. Whitlock was mightily impressive yesterday in seeing off Kirk Shepherd. 5 perfect darts in the second leg, 6 perfect darts in the fourth leg, 6 perfect darts in the ninth leg. It was a very, very eye-catching display indeed, Dan Dawson.
He went berserk, didn't he?
Ladies and gentlemen, first leg, it's Simon.
That's one way of putting it.
Game on.
3.5 legs into that game with Kirk Shepherd. Simon Whitlock's first 9 average was 142. It was just ridiculous.
140.
It is fair to say that Simon Whitlock has thrown those darts in his hand far more impressively than Peter Wright, the world number 3, threw them yesterday. Snakebite has been using Simon Whitlock's spare set of darts this weekend because his luggage doesn't turn up and he's not got one of the 7 billion sets of darts that Peter Snakebite Wright tends to switch around between. So he's got a new set, Simon Whitlock's reserves. And it wasn't great from Peter Wright. We will see if he improves, because he was talking last night. He's quite happy with him. He quite fancies it. He thinks I can go and win this with Simon Whitlock's spare darts.
Oh, look at this, Whitlock. He's back in the treble 20. 103 left after 9.
Yeah, 7 of them yesterday in total against Kirk Shepherd.
140. Simon Yokwa, 103.
Averaged 101.7 yesterday in the end.
Game shot on the and first leg, has, Simon Whitlock.
Certainly helps him keep his average high there. A very, very effective checkout to start things off.
Yeah,
neat
12
and tidy stuff.
Yeah. 12 data, so that's 125 average. I know we're only one leg in. But as I say, 4 legs into that game with Kirk Shepherd. Kirk Shepherd had to take out 170 just to win the first leg that he got on the board. But he actually came back at
59.
It. Simon Whitlock's average ended up at the 101 mark, but it was up near 120 halfway through that game. It was absolutely spellbinding from the wizard. On the Simon Whitlock scale of wizardry, he was right up there towards sort of Harry Potter. He was far, yeah.
I was going to say, more like Voldemort, actually.
Yeah, well, yeah. I mean, he wasn't down at the bottom end by Debbie McGee. He was right at the very top end. It was top stuff from Simon Whitlock.
Sorry.
140!
Debbie McGee being classed as a wizard. She was an assistant to a magician. I think that qualifies her.
Well, that's why she's at the lower end of the scale.
At least she's a real person, unlike Voldemort, who I quoted.
Don't mention his name.
139.
Yeah.
Good response from Robert Owen here. The Welshman, who's only made the quarterfinals of a PDC ranking 45. Event once before. Oh, that was in a Players' 62. Championship event earlier on this year. But he was talking after his first round win. He just felt that a run like this was coming. He's been playing well, and he believes he can do it. He has made board finals and last 16 appearance since that quarterfinal.
70. Robert Urquhart, 32.
Whitlock using the bullseye there. 225s leaves the 170 checkout, which was Simon Whitlock's trademark for a while when he first moved over to the PDC, but he doesn't get a poke at it because Owen levels it up at one apiece.
Well, Simon Whitlock saw Kirk Shepherd take out the 170 checkout yesterday. One of two occasions we've seen that this weekend.
123.
We made the point yesterday, Simon Whitlock, you know, he made
100.
Well, he has made a semi-final this year on the European Tour stage, but apart from that, not a lot else.
Yeah, he always used to produce his best on the Euro Tour stages as well. I mean, he was such a consistent performer, even if other tournaments weren't going so well. I mean, he had that two-year spell pretty much where the big TV tournaments, it just was not going for Whitlock.
60.
And it looked like he might have been sliding out of the world's elite. And it's only the back end of last year, at a six-month spell where he won five titles, and he's back.
58.
He is back. And he's up to number four in the seedings here. But, I mean, that takes incredible reserves of
121.
When you have such a prolonged spell of poor form, to drag it back. But the Euro Tour was always his saving grace during that spell, because even though it wasn't going well on the big TV stages, the Euro Tour, he did turn up and play some good stuff. There were signs that he could do it. 140 for Whitlock leaves him tops, and it looks like we're going to have a third consecutive hold of throw here.
And the thing is, as well, even when he was in a rut, he always insisted that he was playing better than ever. He was capable of playing better than ever.
40.
And he was, you know, he was pretty insistent it was only going to be a matter of time. Maybe a matter of time before he gets the second leg on the board here. Although Owen might well get the chance to pounce in case.
Game shot on the third leg. Simon Whitlock.
Not to be. Whitlock breathes again. 2-1 elite.
Game on.
That is a body blow for Robert Owen. Incredible setup shot. The 180s to leave tops. And it looked as if he was going to get a go at it and nick that leg. But Whitlock, last start into double top. It's good stuff from Owen, though. I mean, we've seen him play a couple of times and win this weekend, but the average is 85 and 92.
140.
I mean, they weren't spellbinding. It was a good win against Christo Reyes. I'm a huge, huge fan of Christo. I think he's going places. And the first ever win 41. For Robert Owen against Christo Reyes. He'd lost the four previous matches he played against him, and a lot of them convincingly as well. So, I mean, it is a massive weekend for Robert Owen, irrespective of what happens 96. In this game. But if he is going to play even better than he's done in the first two games against Simon Whitlock here, that is a great sign for the Welshman. That in one of the biggest games of his darting career, that he can raise his level.
Yeah.
Oh, this is good.
This is very, very nice indeed. Oof.
117.
Well, it's enough to get to a finish. And it's another perfect setup shot from Robert Owen. 180 to leave tops in the last leg. Didn't get a go at it, but ton 40 to leave tops this time. 148's not going to go.
41. Oh, you require 40.
Well, tops it is.
Gave shot on the fourth leg.
Bending the wire, but finding its way through.
Like Simon to throw first. Game on.
And, well, Robert Owen. Averaging just under a ton. Very similar in the averages, in fact, so far. Very similar on the checkouts, too. Very little to separate them in all stats that you look at here.
60.
Winner to face Michael Smith. No seeded casualties so far today. Michael Van Gerwen, Daryl Kearney, Michael Smith all through so far.
What, Joe Cullum?
84.
Well, you know what I mean. The lineup for the quarterfinals so far.
The top seed in that game, went.
Yes. The 60. Man who was expected to go through on the basis of the seedings.
Yeah, so I mean, the last three games this afternoon, Kist Ratajski, Henderson Dedeker, and Beaton Schindler, none of whom seeded players. Guaranteed.
So semi-finalist, unseeded. Yeah.
Well.
And maybe more.
100.
But, fascinating weekend here in Maastricht. First time we've been to Maastricht, and 5,000 fans here, a record crowd for the Euro Tour.
134.
I like the, I don't know if you noticed it, but there's a guy in the crowd who's got a
Simon Yuguan, 102.
One of the signs on the 180 boards, and we'll just talk about that in a moment, actually, with Whitlock on 102 hit. 42 away. 16s then for a 3-2 lead.
70.
I'll have another crack at it. What was on the 180 card?
It said Nederlander nil, Bulgaria 180. It doesn't matter, we have Michael Van Gerwen. So many of this crowd might have half an eye on the football later. Big night tonight for the Dutch as they look to keep their World Cup bid on track. Or get it back on track.
Well,
but the fans here don't care because they've got Van Gerwen.
Well, quite. Because the way the Dutch football team is going, sack that off and watch the darts, lads.
Mm. Don't pay for a ticket to come here and then start watching football on your mobile. That was agonizing.
107. Simon Yuguan, 4.
Well, again, it's a good setup shot from Owen because he's not able to take out the 143. But Whitlock, Madhouse.
2 scores.
Well, well, well. This is the chance that Robert Owen was hoping for. Double 18. Awkward.
Shot on the fifth leg.
Stack attacks. Well, it was more like stacking them underneath each other.
The understacker.
The understacker. But, well, credit to him there because he put himself in position to do that with that 107 visit the time before, treble 20, and then missing the treble 17. But he's been doing that. He's been there or thereabouts 81. In these legs.
Well, Simon Whitlock, 2 out of 11 on the doubles.
140.
You know, Whitlock's grouping of his darts and his scoring visit, that's when you really know that he's in form. You rarely see anybody in darts stick three darts so close together as Simon Whitlock in that treble bed. Let's see if you can do it here.
In between.
No. 100.
Well, it's not quite as close as it has been, but it's still pretty good, isn't it? And that, 20 points on the first 9 average for Simon Whitlock, but it's the doubles that have killed him so far. Six. Because he's a breakdown. Looking to break straight back, though. There you see. 18%.
320 scored after 6 darts. What can he do here?
51.
Well, could have been better, but he's down to 130 with Owen on 260. But Owen can put some pressure on again here. That's an unfortunate second dart. There was a slight deflection, maybe.
Simon Yuguan, 130.
Took it away.
Oh, could get a dart at the bullseye here. That's awkward. Yeah, and unable to find his way
65.
Through the treble.
Robert Yuguan,
what a steal this would be.
2 treble 20s and tops. Not going to happen. Stack it.
60.
Not quite.
Simon Yuguan, 65.
Doesn't want to hit the bullseye. Doesn't, so he's happy. Double 10. And
45.
Now he's not happy.
Robert Yuguan, 100.
Another opportunity for Owen. Almost similar set of circumstances here.
Is it tops tops?
It is. It is tops tops.
Oh!
It looks so inviting as well with that second dart lying as it was. You thought stack attack was just going to slide in on top of it.
Simon Whitlock does break back 3-3.
Whitlock pulled off the top tops finish yesterday, and he was almost on the receiving end there, but he does manage to level things up once again. He's back on terms. He's broken back straight away. And on we go. We've had three matches so far. 6-1, 6-2, 6-2. This one threatening to go the distance.
60.
We've had an abundance of them so far this weekend. SS Enterprise just sailing past. Down the canal, the River Mass.
59.
A boatload of more darts fans arrive in town for the evening session. 17,000 of them outside looking for tickets.
58.
I want to see a big orange flare set off later. I'm not condoning that sort of behavior, by the way, but it would be great to see.
98.
There's not enough orange in this crowd, by the way.
Why? Don't have a go at them. You're praising them earlier on.
60.
I'm not dissing them, I'm just saying. I was expecting more orange clad people here.
It is a strange, I say, record crowd. It's been fantastic. I
mean, 24.
What a venue this is.
Brilliant. It's massive. I got lost yesterday, actually. Just going to get a cup of tea.
It's a trek, isn't it? It's a trek from the back of the hall. But
60.
It is strange. You get the feeling, if this was in Germany, they would be ricocheting off the walls of this place. But the Dutch crowds are just a little bit more subdued than the German ones, aren't they?
Maybe just keeping something in reserve for later on down.
We'll see. Well, that's it. I mean,
84.
We saw Christian Michael van Gerwen firing in a big ton plus average early on. They got pretty noisy for that.
Was that for my benefit, by the way, that shot of people wearing orange? Just to prove a point.
Once again, Robert Owens produces a fantastic setup shot. It's been probably the strongest point of his game so far in this match. 180 to leave tops, 140 to leave tops, 180 to leave 43 here for a third consecutive break of throw. Double 16.
Yeah.
On the 7 there.
And there was the 107 to leave 36 as well. So
throw first.
He's, like I say, he's been really effective at putting himself in positions should the opportunities come along. It's come along once again there, and he's broken back for 4-3. Two breaks to one. Owen, very much in the hunt for a first ever Euro Tour quarterfinal.
And of all the Welsh players we've had here this weekend, Robert Owen was on paper the least likely to be the one through to the final day of action, the final session of action. We get Jamie Lewis, former Euro Tour finalist, Gerwin Price, a former major finalist this year, in fact, you know, World Series player. But Robert Owen, a man who's only made one ranking quarter final before this weekend, is two legs away from making it two. Massive, massive opportunity for stack attack.
140.
Yeah, made the quarterfinals of the second players' championship event of the year. Mentioned it yesterday. He beat Lopkos on route down as well. Only made his European Tour debut in Sindelfingen last October as well. Robert Owen is two legs away from something very, very special indeed.
It was Darryl Gurney that beat him that day in the quarterfinals and the Players' Championship. He's only in deciding leg as well.
Yeah.
Oh, this is another great setup shot from Robert Owen. Once again, he's around about that 200 plus mark, and he fires in a big visit to give himself a realistic chance of seeing out the leg. That's not bad from Simon Whitlock. He needed that treble.
15 darter, and Simon Whitlock has to win. Three legs on the spin, or the former champion at the Dutch Darts Masters is being knocked out by Robert Owen, the unseeded Welshman, the man from Bridgend, looking to make just a second quarter final in his PDC career. And it has been very, very impressive from Robert Owen. All right, I know you're not going to
terrify anybody with a 90 average, but he's hit the right shot at the right time, and those setup shots have been the key for him.
140.
Yeah, Whitlock just unable to find that third treble 20 once again. That's been a real feature for him today. Yesterday, he was rattling them in, but...
81.
The average is well down on yesterday also. He's got plenty of room for at least one more.
100.
Slides one in between those two. But this is on the Whitlock throw. This is not a massive concern for Robert Owen. It's all about, you feel, potentially the next leg when he's thrown first.
99.
I don't think he'll have conceded this one just yet. Oh, unforgivable.
Well,
39.
It looks like he's tried to go tops, tops there. And I don't know why, because Robert Owen is not on a finish. And the way that Robert Owen has been going about his business in this game.
100.
Well, to be honest, after that first dart, I thought he was going to leave something a little bit more handy than 160. That's a bit close to the treble.
Game Sean,
it doesn't matter. It's a 15 dart reply from Simon Whitlock. It is 5-4, and this is the leg. Robert Owen, what have you got?
100.
Vital last dart, that 60 might have just given Whitlock a bit of encouragement, but as it is, Owen is off the mark with a ton. But then again, Whitlock can't find a treble once more here. 59 in reply.
Well, we started with a 12 darter. It's fair to say it has not been that caliber for the rest of the game. You see that fifth leg was a
40.
A brutal one. But that fifth leg is when things started to change. Robert Owen getting the break of throw. Mate Lewis saw a couple of breaks after that, but he's got his nose in front and he's managed to stop Whitlock from edging past him. Whitlock needs to find an extra gear, and it's not happening right now. Robert Owen, this is your chance. First time ever to find yourself. He hadn't won a game on the Euro Tour prior to this weekend. He might be about to go and win three consecutively and set up a meeting with Michael Smith.
Eight darts without a treble here for Whitlock. Make 58. That nine.
And you can see the first nine average, there is 13 points difference between those two. But Robert Owen, his overall average is higher, and it's those setup shots towards the back end of legs that has dragged his average a little higher than Whitlock, and he's hit 50% of his doubles, twice as many as Whitlock. That is what is putting Robert Owen in a position to win this game, because Whitlock is not going to leave himself a finish here, and Robert Owen's got 92. Six darts minimum Robert to see off 136 and book his place in the quarterfinals of a Euro Tour event for the first time in his career. That is perfect. That is perfect.
Get
and that is
shot.
Perfect as well. Robert Owen, the Welshman, into the quarterfinals of a PDC event for just the second time in his career. A huge, huge weekend for Robert Owen. He'll take on the number five seed Michael Smith for a place in the semis tonight. Simon Whitlock, a former champion of the Dutch Darts Masters, knocked out in round three by Stack Attack. Robert Owen, congratulations to that man. Sealing the deal in style with a 136 checkout. We have got four more games this afternoon as we look at the other half of the draw. Three of those matches feature unseeded players, just like Robert Owen is. But it is the two seeds in this half of the draw that duke it out in the next match as the world number three Peter Wright takes on Rob Cross for a place in the quarters.
You hadn't won a match on the Euro Tour stage, and now you're in your first quarter final. You must feel great.
I feel absolutely chuffed a bit. You know, I made the last eight on the Pro Tour serve, which was major for me, and now to make it in the last eight here is absolutely phenomenal, and I'm lost for words, really.
Still, you got to talk to me, so you need to say something. Tonight, you're playing Michael Smith. Have you played him before?
I think I played Michael once in the last 4 years, and he beat me 6-5. I think it was in a UK Open qualifier. You know, it was a close game. Missed doubles and half, both of us did, but we'll see you tonight. I'll get better.
Dames en heren, we gaan hem vanavond terugzien voor de eerste in zijn carrière op de Eurotour in de kwartfinale. Robert Owen!